Good evening, and welcome to another segment of Keeping It Real, Real Talk with Brandon Wright. I'm your host, Brandon Wright. And today, our topic of discussion is going to be mold exposure symptoms. You might be wondering, talk about mold. Why mold? Mold is boring. But there are things about mold that you need to know. You're exposed to mold generally every day, especially if you're living in a home with mold. So mold exposure symptoms are basically symptoms that manifest in the human body due to overexposure or continual exposure to mold in an enclosed or indoor setting. There are three types of mold exposure symptoms: primary, secondary, and tertiary. Now, primary mold exposure symptoms are coughing, sneezing, wheezing, itchy dry eyes, irritated skin, etc. These symptoms are symptoms that are basically associated sometimes with hay fever or common allergies. Have you ever heard someone say, "Oh, my allergies acting up again," or "My allergies are giving me a hard time because of the change of the seasons"? Those are common things people say. But in all actuality, you might be being exposed to mold if you're buying constant allergy medicines and they're not working, you're going home feeling horrible. You might be exposed to mold. Or, put a pin right there. This is Keeping It Real with Brandon. We're going to keep it real. Now, if you're looking at your ceiling fan and it's full of dust, or the top of your TV screen and it's full of dust, or even on your bookshelf and it's full of dust, you need to clean your house. You're not going to know whether you're having allergic reactions to the dust, or the dust is making your allergies act up, or is it mold? The only way we're going to know if you have a dusty house, viewer, please clean it up. Now, secondary mold exposure symptoms. These are symptoms where the primary have progressed, you're still being exposed to mold. You may have short-term memory loss, or even open sores developing on your skin. Sometimes diarrhea, chronic breathing problems. Now, this is where I would think you would have to go see a physician. Another pin. Now, if you see a spot growing on your wall, you know, you just observe it, then as the days progress, as the weeks progress, it gets bigger and bigger and bigger. You really should get something done, or you really should consult with someone and see what it is, because it's not an ingrown house plant. It's mold. And who wants to live in a house with mold? No one. I wouldn't. I would hope my viewers wouldn't either. But then as time progresses and you're continually being exposed to mold, the secondary mold exposure symptoms can even progress to tertiary mold exposure symptoms. Now, these symptoms are the worst, the most severe, the chronic symptoms, such as chronic bronchitis, long-term memory loss. Due to mold exposure, you can definitely and possibly develop cancer. And ultimately, which should have been a quaternary mold exposure symptom, is death. Now, who wants to die due to mold exposure when you can get something done about it? So if you suspect that you have mold in your home, I suggest take a tape lift. Newton Microbial Laboratory is offering a new service called Newton Direct, where you can take a tape lift, send it to us, and we're identified. But it's strictly for identification purposes only. If you're looking to enter into legal matters, we suggest that you consult with a mold inspection company. So if you're looking for accurate, cost-efficient, and immediate results, take a tape lift and send it over to Newton, and we'll get the job done for you. Now, folks, it's been real. It's been nice. Thank you for tuning in to Real Talk with Brandon Wright. Keep it real.